Yar! I'm Kalen from Big Red's Authentic Shine, and today we're using a little bit of molasses to make a whole lot of rum. For equipment, you're gonna need the biggest pot you can find, a big ol' spoon, bucket, and optionally, you're gonna want a pH tester and a hydrometer. Oh yeah, and a still. For ingredients, you're gonna need yeast, molasses, sugar, and yeast nutrient. Step one, fill up your big ass pot with a whole lot of water. Step two, boil your water. While your water's boiling, clean out your bucket.
Holy shit, is that mold?
At this stage, add molasses to the buckets at a ratio of 1/5 the amount of water you're using. So if you're using a 20-liter bucket, add about 4 liters of molasses. So now we take our boiling water and we add it into our buckets. You can add the leftover water to your molasses bucket to help get that last little bit of molasses out. Fill your bucket up till about 80%. You're probably gonna need to boil some more water. Around 4 inches is plenty. Optionally, if you've made alcohol before, you can use some of your back set to replace that water. If you haven't made alcohol before, don't worry about it.
Smells funky.
You can also add your yeast nutrient. I'm using a little bit of ammonium propionate, a multivitamin, and some Epsom salts. Using feed grade molasses, make sure to add some calcium carbonate or non-ionized salt. It's gonna help balance out the ammonium propionate. Okay, your bucket's full. What are you gonna do? Leave it, don't fucking touch it. Let it do its thing. We're gonna add some yeast in about a day once it cools down. If you wanna speed that up, you can add in some cool water. I personally recommend patience. Okay, so I left my big old jugs overnight and they're ready to pitch the yeast. Now to start, we're gonna wake up our yeast by adding some water to the container. Now while the yeast sits, it's gonna foam up a little bit. We're gonna take the hydrometer and check the sugar. Should have your alcohol gravity around 0.8. You don't ever want it to be much higher than 1.1. With rum and the use of molasses, don't be too concerned though, because a lot of those sugars are unfermentable. You also want a pH meter so you can check the acidity. Try keeping it above 5, around 6 is ideal. At this point, our yeast should be ready to pitch, so let's throw it in there. For yeast, I'm keeping it simple, just a little bit of Red Star's active Distiller's yeast. As a bit of a disclaimer, if you want to use an airlock, feel free. I personally don't because it's rum, I don't really care. Okay, that's all for now. We're gonna throw the caps on and leave these for a couple days. And as with anything, we give it a good sniff. Okay. It's been about a week. These suckers are finished fermenting. Now we're gonna backfeed some sugar in, so let's go boil some water. And while we wait for that to boil, I don't know, throw on a TV show or something? Okay, now that the water's boiling, we're gonna add in the sugar. Add in 12% of your total washes, kilograms of sugar.
I made a bit of a spill. Yikes.
Okay, now that the sugar's dissolved, you know, you've made sure you've given it a few mixes, just let it cool down. I'm going to sleep. I'm going to deal with it in the morning. I'm going to clean up my kitchen and just call it a night. Okay, it's the next day, and this is more than cooled down. I take the sugar and top up your buckets. Okay, these have finished fermenting, so let's get the still prepped. Mr. Bombastic, we order some bombastic, romantic, fantastic lover. Shaggy. Mr. Lover, lover. Now Mr. Lover, lover. Girl. Mr. Lover, lover. Now Mr. Lover, lover. She call me Mr. Bombastic. Send me fantastic. Me on me box, she says I'm Mr. Romantic. Call me fantastic. Touch me on me box, she says I'm Mr. Smooth, just like a silk. Soft and cuddly, hug me up like a quilt. I'm a lyrical lover. Now take me thin or filled with my sexual physique. You know me well, Bill. Do me, oh my, well, well, can't you tell? I'm just like a turtle. Okay, now that everything's been distilled and it's ready for blending, go taste your jars, decide where your heart cut is, and proof it down. Okay, so I've tasted all the jars and these are the ones I'm putting in the blend. It ranges from almost slightly cough medicine-y but with a very nice molasses flavor to apricot, orange peel, and then eventually almost barnyard, tobacco, farm flavors. So I'm not gonna include as much of this. I'm gonna really try and strive for this, but I wanna pick and choose some from the front and the finish. I did end up throwing away a lot of jars on this. I'm doing this one very tight with some deep cuts. Okay, now that I've got my blend, it's time to proof it down. Okay, so if you want a white rum, that's awesome, you're done. Just bottle, drink your mix, you're good. But if you want to make some dark rum, we're gonna have to make some rum essence. So take a little bit of Dunder, a little bit of Hearts, and create a 50-50 mixture of them. You're also gonna want to put the rest of your rum on some oak. Personally, I don't have a barrel, so I'm using a carboy filled with oak chips. It gets the job done. Okay, so the rum essence has had about a week to settle. The settlement's there at the bottom. And the biggest thing with this when you're adding it in is you want between 40 and 80 milliliters per liter of wash. I have 4 liters here, so I'm gonna add between 200 and 220 milliliters because I want a bit of a lighter rum. Now that the rum's had time to age, I'm gonna bottle it.
Hey, the video's all finished, but there's one thing I'm yet to do. It's damn good rum.